Just look at the landscape around us and how remote this is. And then jutting out of the side of this Arctic mountain is the Svalbard Global Seed Vault. And we have all been very excited to actually get inside and see for ourselves how what's being done here plays a very vital role when it comes to trying to mitigate against the consequences of climate change. So this is it.
This is it. This is the vault. This is what is built for humanity to survive. This is the Svalbard Global Seed Vault. It's here since 2008, built by the government of Norway. And it's one of the most amazing things you're going to see in your life. Yep, they look funny, but they protect you against ice falling down in the vault.
It's that cold.
It's that cold. So that's about 150 meters down into the mountain. This is becoming the permafrost here in granite. They built this like they built the tunnels in the Alps with a big machine, big excavator. Took about 2 years to build. And it's built to last for a very long time. This is meant to be your way out if the power fails, if there is no lights, so you find your way out of the vault. So the seed deposit works like with any bank and a safe deposit storage in the basement of the bank. You bring your own seeds. You, as a depositing institution, you own them and you keep them, and only you can determine what happens with them. This is the main door to the active vault, one of the three vaults that we have. It's all frozen up because inside it's minus 18 Celsius year round. And this is typically the place everyone wants to have a picture taken. This is world agriculture behind that door. Everything you're going to need for the world to survive in terms of agriculture is safely kept here for the future. We have 860,000 types of crops. Each probe has 100 to 1,000 corns. So if you look at the number of individual grains in here, it could be close to a billion.
My nose is going to fall off already.
You need to keep warm here with everything that you can. And when you go inside, it gets colder because of the draft of the AC. You could go back to Svalbard and recreate agriculture in the world, which I find an amazing concept.
In the event of a cataclysmic occurrence, this would stay and preserve these seeds for how long?
We have minus 18 Celsius in here. It would go up to minus 8, minus 7 after a few years. But then even at that temperature, most of the seeds can stay for many, many years, 10, 20, 30 years time. So you have a lot of time to think about what to do, even if power fails here and doesn't get restored. It's a safe place.
It is truly remarkable and such a unique experience. You know, the general population doesn't have access to this vault, and we're among the few who have actually been inside. And as Michael said, it really does make you pause and think about how what is being done here is really helping to safeguard our future.